Understanding rhythm strips. EKG or ECG both stand for electrocardiogram. Let's break this word down. Electrical, current moving from one area to another. Cardio, referring to the heart. Graph displays the electricity moving through the heart. This video will focus on the graph part, and future videos will build on top of this foundation. The graph shows time horizontally and amplitude vertically. The graph has smaller boxes inside larger boxes. 25 small boxes, 5 columns and 5 rows, are in one large box. The reason for these boxes is to make it easy to count the time between electrical events. When we get into measuring the ECG waves, knowing how to measure the time interval between electrical events will help in diagnosing heart abnormalities. Let me say this another way. A metronome keeps consistent rhythm. If we graph a rhythm from a metronome, it'll be easy to see and hear when the metronome malfunctioned. A normal ECG recording should keep a consistent rhythm, very much like the metronome. An abnormal ECG shows where the rhythm is off and is used to diagnose where the abnormality in electrical current has occurred. So first, let's focus on how to use the graph to measure electrical impulses. The rhythm strips has smaller boxes within a larger box. Each small box represents 0.04 of a second. 5 small boxes are in one large box. So 0.04 times 5 small boxes equals 0.20 seconds in one large box. And just like 5 $20 bills equals $100, 5 large boxes equals 1 second. Now let's discuss the 6-second method of calculating heart rate, which is preferred by many medical professionals. The reason this method is preferred is because counting 1 minute would be a very long strip and would get confusing. But 6 seconds is a manageable length of time. After counting the number of beats in 6 seconds and multiplying that by 10, that number is your heart rate. Let's do one. Here's a 6-second strip. How many beats are in this strip? 5 times 10 equals 50 beats per minute. Let's do another one, just because this is so much fun. How many beats in this 6-second strip? 8 beats times 10, the heart rate is 80. There's another method commonly used, but this one you just have to memorize. And you should skip this part if you are still working on what we've just talked about. You can always come back later if you want, but learning what we've already talked about will get you going. The square counting method is used to get a quick estimate, and all that is needed is 2 beats. However, I will not go into great detail on why this method works. There are many explanations online if you want that much detail. Later videos, I will bring up this square counting method again where it is more relevant. To use this method, locate the tall waveform and find the one that lines up on the edge of a large box. The first large box after the one that you've lined up is considered to be 300 beats per minute. The second large box represents 150 beats per minute. And the third large box equals 100. The fourth box equals 75. And the fifth large box is 60 beats per minute. This is just straight memorization of the value of each box, and it can get more complex if you like doing math. But if you have 2 beats, you can get an estimate of the heart rate. Let's do 2 examples. First, locate the tall waveform and find the one that lines up on the edge of a large box. Add the values of each box between the tall waveforms, and you will have a rate of 150. Let's do one more. Locate the tall waveform and find the one that lines up on the edge of the large box. Now add the values of each box. Then where the second tall wave lands, give it an estimate about 75 beats per minute. So this is a foundation that we will build on. The next video will start explaining the recorded pattern produced by the ECG machine. Understanding the concepts in this video will be key to continuing your ECG education.